Welcome to our first Presbyterian video series. We are a Reformed church, and so the question today is, what is a Reformed church? Well, strictly speaking, a Reformed church is a church that comes from the 16th and 17th century Protestant Reformation. So in order to understand what a Reformed church really is, we have to understand what the Protestant Reformation is. Now, the Protestant Reformation began in 1517 when a German Augustinian monk by the name of Martin Luther was reading Romans and Galatians, and as he's trying to understand this biblical doctrine of salvation that the Apostle Paul is writing about, he's thinking this is nothing like what the Western medieval Roman Popish Church teaches. This is not what we teach about salvation. And so as he considers these things and he starts to formulate Paul's doctrine of salvation, that is, that salvation, according to Scripture alone, is by God's grace alone, through faith alone, in Christ alone, and for the glory of God alone. And these became known as the five solas of the Reformation: sola scriptura, sola gratia, sola fide, solus Christus, and soli Deo gloria. On the other hand, what the Western medieval Roman church taught was that you were saved at baptism by infused grace, and you remain saved throughout your life by cooperating with God's grace. As Luther's teachings against Rome began to spread, so did Reform all throughout Europe. Now, following the work of Martin Luther, many other reformers in other parts of Europe picked up on what he was teaching, and they attempted to reform the churches in their own cities and countries. For example, Martin Bucer in Strasbourg, Germany, John Calvin in Geneva, Switzerland, Heinrich Bullinger in Zurich, Switzerland, Zacharias Ursinus in Heidelberg, Germany, Guy Debray in Belgium, John Knox in Scotland. They all began formulating these doctrines, and what they did was they put them down in writing. So you have these churches who are putting down what they believe the Bible teaches into these documents, and they begin to say, here are what we believe as these churches who are reformed according to the Word of God. Now, that became a mouthful, so what they did was they called themselves the Reformed churches. And each geographical region had their own Reformed church. So in order to distinguish themselves from the Roman church, these men, these reformers, wrote down what they believed in their confessions and their catechisms. Their confessions were what they believed the Bible taught, and their catechisms were their mode of teaching what they believed the Bible taught. Some of these confessions include the Geneva Confession of 1536, the Belgic Confession of 1561, the Heidelberg Catechism of 1567, the Canons of Dort of 1618, and the Westminster Standards written in the 1640s. As you can see, these confessional church documents were in existence long before there was even such thing as a United States of America. So long before the United States of America was even in existence, Reformed churches existed. These distinguishing documents set the Reformers and the Reformed churches apart from the Western Roman medieval church, as well as other sects like the Pietists, the Anabaptists, and other radical sects of the Reformation. So that brings us back to the original question. What is a Reformed church? The churches that came from the 16th and 17th century Protestant Reformation and wrote down what they believed in their church documents, their confessions, and their catechisms. These were the churches that were reformed according to the Word of God, and since that was a mouthful, they called themselves the Reformed churches. So to say one is Reformed, or to say you go to a Reformed church, means you subscribe to, or your church subscribes to, these documents, these confessions and catechisms written in the 16th and 17th centuries. So to put it another way, we are Reformed because we're not Roman Catholic, we're not Methodist, we're not Baptist, we're not Pentecostal, we are Reformed. We're not from the churches of the revival of the 18th and 19th centuries in the United States of America. We're not a strictly American church. We are Reformed. Now, if you've never heard these things before, and maybe they're intriguing to you, I want to invite you to come to our church. Come see what Reformed, biblical, simple worship looks like. Come see our theology in action. Come see what it is that we teach. We invite you to our worship service, which is at 10 a.m. on Sundays and 5 p.m. on Sunday nights. These are two separate worship services. We also want to invite you to one of our Bible studies. We have a Wednesday night Bible study, followed by a meal and fellowship time. We also have a Thursday afternoon ladies' Bible study at 1 p.m. We also have a Sunday school, which goes throughout the whole year. In the springtime, we teach a theology class, and in the fall, we teach a church history class. So what I want to do now is recommend a couple of different books for you if some of these things are intriguing. First, we have this book here by Malcolm Watts. It's called What is a Reformed Church? He goes through some of the basics about what a Reformed Church is, what it isn't, and what we believe. Next, we have this, Welcome to a Reformed Church. This one gets into a little bit more detail, and there's sections on worship and ecclesiology, salvation. Highly recommend that book as well. And here's a very simple book. This one's only a few bucks. You can get this one from PNR, Basics of the Faith, and it is What is a Reformed Faith? Also, if you come and you don't have a Bible, we'd love to give you a Bible. This is the English Standard Version, and it is our gift to you if you come and visit us. So I look forward to seeing you. And again, this is First Presbyterian Church of Bad Axe, a Reformed Church.